Please remain standing as we now ask God's blessing upon the class of 2011 and upon this great occasion. Gracious God, it is with great thanksgiving and with joy and celebration that we gather this evening to celebrate not only the graduation from Laurel Hall of these eighth graders, but also the school that and all those who provided for their education, the staff and teachers, during the years that they spent here. We ask that your spirit might guide this evening in all that we do and we say, that it might be pleasing to you. O Lord, we ask this in your name. Amen.
Will everyone please stand for the pledges to the American Christian flags. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now to the Christian flag. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for his kingdom it stands, united all his followers in service and in love.
Thank you, and you may be seated. Well, welcome to this wonderful celebration of Laurel Hall's class of 2011. Welcome to family and friends of our graduates. My name is Kathleen Hayworth, and I'm very proud to be the principal of Laurel Hall School, and especially of this class of 2011. Before we go any further in tonight's program, you see our faculty gathered around you, and I know that our graduates would not be where they are today, in part without our wonderful faculty, because so many of them have been with us for so many years. So please join me in thanking our wonderful Laurel Hall faculty for their inspiration. I would ask that they can take their seats now and enjoy the program. Thank you so much. You know, usually I spend a couple days preparing a speech for the graduating class, but this class has been so exceptional. I can really speak from the heart. I can tell you, as parents and family and friends, we hate to see them go. This has just been an exceptional group of students. As you will hear throughout the evening, they're scholars, they're athletes, they're musicians. They're creative, they're abstract thinkers. They've grown into these wonderful young people. And parents, you should be so proud of them because they're polite, they're sensitive, they have compassion. And I want to thank each one of you, as I've had a very interesting year, for being so caring and loving and sensitive. I've been so impressed with just the way you care about each other, and we're so proud of you. And class, I think there's some people that we would like to thank for also getting you this far. Let's give a big round of applause to your parents. What I do like to prepare for each graduation is just a few statistics about the class and how they came to us. I can tell you that 15 of our students began in the Early Childhood Center. 19 joined us in kindergarten, 23 joined us along the way in elementary school, and 18 of them joined us for middle school. So we've been a family for quite a while in one way or another. 7% of our students graduating tonight graduate with Distinguished High Honors of 4.0. 5% Distinguished High Honors 3.95 to 3.99. 60% of the class graduating with high honors, 3.50 to 3.94. And 13% of the class honors 3.20 to 3.49. Even the high schools remarked when we were sending off the records about what an exceptionally bright class this is. So we are so, so proud of you. To to tell you a little bit more about the class, I'm pleased to introduce at this time our Associated Student Body President, Tess Appelblasa.
Hi, everyone. Thank you. I'll be honest, it took me a while to write this speech. It may be because I spend too much time on Facebook and texting, but the truth is, I didn't know what I wanted to talk about. So I went looking for inspiration. I started listening to 50 Cent and then moved on to Tupac, but even that didn't work. I talked to my friends and family and none of it helped. Then I realized where to go, my photo library. I was certain that somewhere in all those photographs, I would get the inspiration I was looking for. Unfortunately, there were 7,000 photos, so I didn't know where to begin. Obviously, I could talk about how much we've all changed. I could even show you a photo of Ryan Boyd to prove it, who, as we all know, has gone from a 75-pound weakling into the Incredible Hulk. And of course, I could talk about all those dorky haircuts, the braces, changing voices, and of course the skirts that have throughout the years gotten shorter and shorter. But the thing is, I know we've changed. Our parents definitely know we've changed. So I think I'll skip the look how much we've changed part of the speech. Besides, as I stared at all those photos, as I went from yearly field trips at Alpine to Catalina, and from dance to dance, teacher to teacher, I suddenly realized what I needed to say. It was staring me in the face, just two simple words. Thank you. Thank you, Laurel Hall, for not only making us smarter, but better people. And thank you, Mrs. Hayworth, Mrs. Barami, and Ms. Evans, for all your hard work and dedication to the school. Thank you, Mr. Meyer, for Groove Shark. Thank you, Ms. Kachumba, for the candy. Ms. Heller, for ASB and teaching us to die for the ball. Ms. Jones, what can I say? Thank you for 10 incredible days on the East Coast. Thank you, Ms. Dodgy, for being so hip. Ms. Bergstrom, for abbreviating all your words and for all those facial expressions when you get angry. Thank you to our school chefs for getting us excited about Beef Taco Day. Thank you, Mr. Morales, for those smiles and hugs. And Mr. Schwartz, thank you for every single gasket you've ever blown. And if... of course... Of course, I could keep going on, but I only have 3 minutes. So let me just say thank you to every teacher we've ever had, from Mrs. Lulu in preschool to Ms. Wolfolk in eighth grade, every teacher in between. Your kindness and knowledge will stay with us for the rest of our lives. You have made us a difference in who we are. We may leave this school forever, but we will always be Hornets. I'd also like to thank all the parents of Laurel Hall. We may not show it, but you are all truly appreciated. From packing our lunches, to coming to our sports events, from cheering us on, staying up late to help with those last minute essay corrections, and of course, thank you for every time you drove us back to school when we forgot something in our lockers. You think we don't notice, but we do. In other words, thank you for all you do. And finally, I can't go any further until I thank 75 of the most important people in this church, and that's the Laurel Hall class of 2011. I think you'd all agree that we have a pretty unique class, and each person brings something special to this grade. From the way Mary Rose can always cheer you up, to the way that Ian and Justin can make you laugh in the worst times, or how Jack can always get a party started, or Aaron's perfect hair, or the way everyone has Lauren and Nick B correct their papers, and nobody can put an outfit together like Sage, Wallace, or Nicole, and how about Chelsea's smile, or how artistic Marcella is, and nobody can light up a room like Spencer. And of course, there is incredible athletes, Austin, Michael, Zare, Sophia, Sabrina. And how about our boys' football, baseball, and basketball teams, all three winning championships this year. Everywhere you look, there is talent and style. Spirited cheerleaders, the wonderful band, the bells, the drama, ASB, yearbook. But it's not just the talent in this class that matters, or how athletic or smart we are. What really makes this class so special is what's on the inside. This is the kindest, most generous, encouraging, and loving class there is, and it's these qualities I'm most grateful for. It's these qualities I will miss the most, along with every single moment we've ever been lucky to share. From nap time in preschool to our last dance at night out, together we have created the most perfect photograph. I will always be grateful for this Laurel Hall experience. Thank you, I love you all so much. I would now like to introduce the 8th grade handball choir under the direction of Ms. Cook.
Thank you. It's a real hug fest. Has been since about 9 o'clock this morning. This year we did something a little different with our salutatorians. In the past, students who had a 3.956 to 3.99 were the salutatorians, but we decided we wanted to open the field up to any student who may have a message of inspiration for you and for their fellow students. So we had a little competition, so to speak. This year, students submitted essays for consideration. Three of the eighth grade students, Jack Clayman, Jesse Manos, and Bowen, with the help of three teachers, Mrs. Miller, Mrs. Schooley, and Mrs. Lau, read the submissions with no names, and then they chose two students to share their thoughts with us tonight. Those two students are Megan Lisey and Sage Polanco.
Back at my 11 years at Laurel Hall, I think of all the wonderful times I've had with my loving friends, my tremendous teachers, and the supportive staff. As I think about all the times we have had together, I realize that the people of Laurel Hall have truly become a family to me. Even though a variety of us are going our separate ways, I know that my love for you will never diminish. All of us eighth graders have many memories that we will never forget, from science experiments to reading Shakespeare, from class trips with Ms. Jones to band tour with Mr. Zick, and from chilling in Mr. Meyer's room to talking about what was on TV the previous night with Mrs. Bergstrom, our recollections will never fade. Together, we have also accomplished many goals. We have all developed as young women and young men with attitudes fit for high school. We have made strong bonds with friends we will have forever. Along with the several other 11-year Laurel Hall graduates, Laurel Hall has become a home to me. Due to having a sister and a brother graduate from here, and a mother who works on campus, I knew what Laurel Hall had in store for me. After hearing about all the amazing and helpful teachers and staff, I knew that I was in good hands. From Ms. Harrison to Mrs. Malepshi, Ms. Barclay to Mrs. Schooley, Mrs. Semmel to Ms. Holton, and from Ms. Sem to Ms. Heller to Ms. Bergstrom, I have learned many new things and accomplished more goals than I ever thought possible. Laurel Hall has brought us happiness, friendship, and infinite memories, and we will still be a part of this Laurel Hall family even after we are gone. Here we are, the class of 2011, at the end of a very significant phase in our lives. I know that we have all been very anxious for this moment. Even though we are about to graduate and go our separate ways, Laurel Hall will be in each and every one of our hearts forever. We are about to walk out those doors and know that we will never be students attending Laurel Hall again. For some, this is a very important and tear-jerking moment, and for others, you cannot wait to get out of here. But forever you are, you know that Laurel Hall has helped to make you the person you are today and has prepared you for the high school you will attend in the fall. High school is a very important part of a person's life. It can help determine the person you will be. Even though high school is a terrifying part of life, we will all learn new things. Thank you, Laurel Hall, for preparing us for this frightening yet exciting new journey we will soon embark on. Now, as we move forward into this new phase of our lives, I encourage you all to continue with confidence, joy, and excitement. The future is what we make it, and we can make it a great future. Our dreams can lead us down a path to success, so dream big. Dream of a future where everyone cares for one another, regardless of who they are or where they come from. Dream of a better world and do your part towards making it a reality. Memories, accomplishments, dreams. Laurel Hall has given us all these amazing gifts and more. I will never forget the friends I have made, the challenges that we have met, and the many things that we have learned here at Laurel Hall. I want to thank each and every one of my teachers for guiding me through this sacred journey and for helping me prepare for the next one. I also want to thank Mrs. Hayworth, Mrs. Barami, and Mrs. Evans for the guidance and support throughout my elementary and middle school years. As we move on to our new adventures, I congratulate each and every member of the class of 2011.
Hey everyone, I'm here today to take you back in time. a time where there are only 9 planets, and number 2 pencils with pencil of choice. That is 2002. Yes, for all you out there, it seems like just yesterday, and it does for me too. Back then, I was about 6 years old, enrolled in kindergarten for the 2nd time in a row. I loved it so much I did it twice. I remember my first friend and how I played with her because I liked her lunchbox. I came home and told my parents about the great sleep I had and how nice my teacher was. Well, I woke up the next day and I was beginning middle school. Lockers, Mr. Meyer, an extended lunch period. I thought I was really on top of the world. Well, I was deeply mistaken when I was stuffed in a locker by a large 8th grader the 2nd week of school. It's okay, I wasn't too traumatized. In fact, I thought it was kind of fun. After I came home from school that day, I woke up the next morning as an 8th grader, and I learned what a real friendship was. I developed a love for music, I saw another, more grown-up side of myself, and I learned to love my family in a way I'd never before. This year, I experienced change, a change for the better. Just when I thought I finally had this school all figured out, I had to say goodbye. Goodbye not to just a place I spent a serious part of my life in, but a family that has seen me grow up from being a little girl at 6 to an awkward tween at 14. We all remember the sports you played and how we had to trust our team members to be there for the ball or just to be there to lift our spirits. Laurel Hall taught us to trust each other because we're all there to help each other in sports, in the classrooms, and in all the activities we do as a team. In my class, we all want each other to succeed. For example, in Catalina, we participated in a team building exercise to further our trust in one another. I remember hesitating during the trust fall with a partner I've known since kindergarten. I overcame the fear because everyone encouraged me by telling me if one person could do it, we all could do it. Our class of 2011 is a team. We all know each other's strengths and weaknesses, which is not necessarily a good thing, but in our case, it was. The trust we have in each other is a gift, not only Laurel Hall, but also God has taught us to embrace. Another useful thing Laurel Hall taught me is how to juggle, because it is useful when dealing with your taxes later on in life. Well, not really. But Laurel Hall taught me to open my heart to God, and learning this has made me a better person. The most valuable lesson learned was to love thy neighbor. This lesson applied to loving each other as a class and will forever apply in our lives. I can't believe we have come this far. Thank you to all the teachers that has touched our lives in learning. Thank you, Laurel Hall, class of 2011, for everything you gave us. And thank you, parents, for being there to help us grow.
I was lucky enough to go on the band tour again this year, and I have heard this song numerous times, and I don't get tired of it. I heard it again this morning and just loved it. So we are going to hear the eighth grade members of the Laurel Hall Band perform Soul Bossa Nova by Quincy Jones under the direction of Damon Zick.
And as the band is getting set up, I just have two quick things. First of all, in your programs, you'll notice the recessional is Mambo number 5, and the recording for that is actually the entire middle school band taken from one of their final band tour concerts. So it doesn't mention that in the program, but when you hear it over the loudspeaker, that's a recording of our band. And then the second thing I just wanted real quickly is I wanted all the folks who started with me in 4th grade to raise your hand. So if you look, I think I have 10 of them up there, should be. And the really cool thing about this class is those 10 started out, and I actually see another one that started in 4th grade sitting in the front row there, went to another school. But the enthusiasm of this class inspired others to join. So if you look, we have 10, but there's almost doubled in size over the course of the 8 years. So we got a fantastic 8th grade. So here's Soul Bossa Nova. Thank you.
Well, as Mrs. Hayworth already mentioned, we've got a bunch of really very smart kids with very high honors, and this year we actually have a whopping 5 valedictorians. That means a perfect 4.0 for 7th and 8th grade. That means not even one A minus in anything. We're going to hear from two of them right now, and that will be Bowen Bailey and Nicole Che.
Today is the big day. Today is the day that I, along with my classmates in the class of 2011, graduate from Laurel Hall. Some of my classmates have been here since preschool, others since kindergarten, and others from every grade along the way. I came to Laurel Hall in third grade. I only knew one person, and I was very scared. My classmates immediately took me in, and I began my life at Laurel Hall. Throughout my years here, I have, along with my classmates, accomplished many things. Just this year, I was part of a championship football team, and some of my closest friends won the basketball and baseball championships. We just got back from the East Coast trip, and that was very tiring for most of us, yet extremely fun. Thank you, Ms. Jones. On that trip, we enjoyed many different historical places together and bonded even more as a class. But we are all here tonight to celebrate a new chapter in our lives, a chapter that begins with us leaving here tonight. We will continue this chapter into high school. 52% of the graduating class will be attending Notre Dame. I'll be continuing my chapter at Loyola along with 4 of my good friends. This is also the end of a very important chapter in our lives. If we could all just take a second to think about what is happening. We are leaving Laurel Hall. Some have only been here 1 year, others 12. We are never coming to school here again, and that is both an accomplishment and an upsetting fact. But then again, we are all excited to begin a new 4 years of meeting people and playing new sports and doing other activities. Think about what is happening right now. Right now, well, a little while ago, there was a crisis in Libya. We just killed Osama bin Laden, and we just came back from our East Coast trip. In 4 years, this will all be history. We will have gone through high school and be ready to attend college. For those who have been at Laurel Hall 12 years, high school will only be a third of the time you've spent at Laurel Hall. We have all made great friends here and become part of a wonderful family. Throughout our time at Laurel Hall, we have learned how to learn. We have also learned the skills needed to attend high school and how to succeed. I'd like to thank all my teachers over the years, Ms. Schooley, Ms. Semmel, Ms. Miller, Mrs. Sidman, Ms. Evans, Ms. Hecox, Ms. Jones, Ms. Heller, Mr. Sidman, Mr. Meyer, Ms. Bergstrom, Ms. Kachumba, Ms. Cook, Ms. Revere, Ms. Dachi, Ms. Wolfolk, and Mrs. Berry, for preparing me for the next stage of my life. I'd also like to thank all my coaches over the years, Mr. Schwartz, Coach Moore, and Mr. Malice, and all my other coaches for preparing me for the next stage of sports. I especially like to thank my parents. My mom and dad have never really pressured me about my grades, but they have always said, as long as I prepare and try my best, they do not care what the outcome is. This does not mean that they weren't supportive and didn't help me. They're always there whenever I needed help or guidance, and they helped me to do my best. They encouraged me, and my best effort was always enough. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for always supporting me, and I love you both very much. I'd also like to thank my classmates. You guys have always been kind and supportive, and there's no other group of kids that I would rather have spent the last 6 years with. Thank you, and good luck in high school.
Dear fellow students, teachers, faculties, and families of Laurel Hall School, I am beyond honored to share one's message with you all on this very memorable occasion. It has been quite a life-changing journey, some even from preschool leading up to our final year of eighth grade in an environment that has become so dear to us all. Throughout our times at Laurel Hall, we have learned numerous life lessons that have prepared us to reach the highest points of success. The past few years of our lives create an unforgettable past, a celebration of the present, and excitements in the future yet to come. As the class of 2011, we have had countless unforgettable memories together. Our historic East Coast trip was just one of those many memorable experiences. This trip was an incredible 10-day journey spent with hardworking teachers in addition to wonderful classmates. Throughout this journey, I feel that as a group, we took care of one another and acted as a true family. We gained much teamwork on this historic trip by helping and caring for one another. As a class and individual, we have accomplished so much this year and have prepared for the next step of our lives. We gather here today to celebrate and acknowledge the accomplishments all have made throughout our journeys at Laurel Hall School. This is an extremely crucial step and phase in our lives when we not only commemorate our past, but also start to experience a new chapter. The start of the most vital stage of our lives will be leaving a majority of our classmates whom we have known either for many years now or for just 1 year. Although we may be attending different high schools than some of our friends, with the strong bonds created, those friendships will be everlasting. Today, as we graduate from Laurel Hall School, we can only imagine what the future holds for each and every one of us. Our journeys of being students at Laurel Hall have taught us the abilities to learn and succeed, to have a voice and make a difference in the future, in addition to helping the problems that face society with solutions. Our past cherished memories that were spent together, present recognitions of the graduating class of 2011, and future journeys to come will have formed an incredible life experience for us all. Laurel Hall School has taught us the crucial qualities needed in order to promote success. I am extremely grateful for each and every teacher who I have had the privilege to be in class with. It has been an honor to be a part of the graduating class of 2011 and an unforgettable journey that I will carry throughout the rest of my life. Thank you, Laurel Hall.
Aaron Orcutt and Lauren Kelly came to Mr. Hayworth back when we were starting this process and shared with him that they had an arrangement that they wanted to share at graduation, and we heard it this morning for the first time, and it really is the most gorgeous. They did this without any adult supervision, I think. Moms might be able to tell me differently. I know Mr. Hayward didn't help them at all. An absolutely gorgeous arrangement of Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Valedictorians are Nick Bunsuka, Zare Kalustian, and Lauren Kelly.
I am thankful for many things, for all my years at Laurel Hall, for all the lessons I've learned, for all the friends I've made. The great teachers here have not only helped guide our education, but have made us curious about the world, encouraged us to think outside the box, and made us believe in ourselves. The knowledge we gained was not only procured in our classrooms or textbooks. At Laurel Hall, lessons in honor, integrity, faith, and friendship were a way of life. It's these qualities that will help us succeed not only in high school and college, but in life. So to Ms. Hayworth, Ms. Barami, and Ms. Evans, thank you for helping us get through middle school and making sure we all got into a good high school. Thank you, Ms. Bergstrom, for teaching us many lessons ranging from proper grammar to creative writing. Mr. Zick and Mr. Hayworth, you have given me a great gift, a lifelong passion for music. Mr. Meyer and Ms. Kachumba, thank you for making math, science, and history not only educational, but fun. And the pizza and candy didn't hurt either. Ms. Barry, thank you for putting together a great yearbook that will be enjoyable for many years to come. Ms. Dachi, thank you for making us challenge our beliefs and for giving us the tools to decide what's right and what's wrong. Mr. Schwartz and Ms. Jones, you've taught us that not all of us can be great athletes, but if you try your best, sometimes that's good enough. And an extra special thanks to Ms. Jones for organizing the best field trips. Thank you, Ms. Woolfolk. I know you pride yourself on being one of the meanest teachers here, but behind that serious face is a big, kind heart. And to the class of 2011, with all your unique personalities and quirks, your friendship has been invaluable to me. I don't know whether or not we will cross paths again after today, but what I do know is that there's potential in each and every one of you to do great things. Lastly, to my mom, dad, and grandparents, your endless love and support have shown me that all things are possible. Eleanor Powell once wrote, "What we are is God's gift to us. What we become is our gift to God." So go forward, believe in yourself, never give up, and let today be the beginning of a new journey, a great adventure, and a life well lived. Thank you.
I could start by saying how individuality is the most important thing to future success, but I would be saying that to our entire class of 75, dressed here in front of me in identical caps and gowns. Or I could stress that the key to future success is being a well-prepared team player that sacrifices his or her own individuality for the greater gain of the whole team. But that would be insulting to the individuals that we all are. So instead, I will defend the belief that the real key to success is maintaining the balance of being your individual self while at the same time preparing and training for the common good. But before extending my thoughts on these matters, I would first like to thank the administration, our pastor and spiritual leaders, and all of our teachers and the staff, and of course all of our parents, for the wonderful and fulfilling experience that we all shared during our time here at Laurel Hall. I would also like to thank the entire 2011 eighth grade class of Laurel Hall for being the best class ever. And as a sample from only this past year, our class is the one that will send almost all of our graduates to a long list of exceptional high schools of our choice. Our class is the one that won the football, basketball, and baseball league championships. Our class is responsible for performing a wide variety of community service. Our class was one of the classes responsible for establishing the Global Marketplace event. And this year, our event raised almost $4,000 that was donated to charitable causes. These were accomplished by the efforts of individuals and teams of individuals. Truly, this Laurel Hall 8th grade class of 2011 is exceptional, unforgettable. Thank you for the memories that we should all celebrate for the rest of our lives. I like to think of our class as one big family, bonded together forever through the spirit of these past years, through the recollection of these wonderful times. A large cohesive unit that collectively is unique unto itself, as unique as each and every individual that makes up our class. And although we will be physically apart in the coming years, we will stay together in the security, knowledge, and life experiences that we have obtained from Laurel Hall. It is said that graduates can feel uneasy and even feel anxiety when faced with the significant changes that come with graduation. But I believe that one should be excited about such new and unknown challenges, to face them head on, to embrace them, and to live them to our full potential. Each and every one of us, in his or her own unique and individual way, will go on to achieve academic, athletic, and or talent-related accomplishments for which we have prepared for, and all of which will make up the legacy of our class. And as we progress and continue to grow and mature into the young men and women that will lead our communities, we should all remember our common bonds established here, the balance of each of us as individuals and collectively as the 2011 eighth grade class of Laurel Hall. Fellow classmates, while it is hard to say goodbye, we will all go forward from here and make our place in the future, the new generation that is us, and it will be a generation of wisdom, a generation of strength, and a generation of energy that started for us all right here at Laurel Hall. Thank you.
To all my fellow graduates, I'm honored to speak here at our Laurel Hall Class of 2011 graduation. As we gaze back on our years here, it is clear how much we have all grown and learned from our experiences. The variety of assignments and tasks that were a part of our time here have truly shown us the importance of knowledge and helped us to mature over the years. We were challenged to chase after our dreams and take pride in what we did. Our trips to Sacramento, Astro Camp, Alpine, CME, and the East Coast have also helped us grow as independent individuals. As a class, we have made many great accomplishments that stand out tremendously. Numerous sports championships, two extremely successful musicals, a spectacular band, bell, choir, and string group, and so much more make this class truly amazing. In just a few short months, we will be off to high school in a new environment we are not used to, with hundreds of new people we have never seen or met before. It's exciting, but at the same time, terrifying. Laurel Hall has definitely prepared me for the next 4 years in high school. One thing I've learned to understand is this: you are only as great as you say you are. If you believe that you can achieve something, you will. I believe that we will all accomplish great things in high school, no matter where we are going. I am so grateful to have attended Laurel Hall for 9 years, and there are so many people I could not thank enough. To our teachers, thank you very much for being so understanding and teaching us everything you could to prepare us for the next step in life. The best teachers teach from the heart, not from the book. I know I only have a few minutes, but I really want to personally thank Mrs. Evans, Mrs. Aiken, Mrs. Harvey, Mrs. Barkley, Mrs. Semmel, Mrs. Miller, Mrs. Sidman, Ms. Wolfolk, Ms. Rivera, Mrs. Wilkie, Mrs. Hecox, Mr. Sidman, Ms. Senf, Mr. Evans, Ms. Heller, Mr. Schwartz, Ms. Jones, Mrs. Dauchy, Mr. Hayworth, Ms. Kachumba, Mr. Meyer, Mrs. Bergstrom, Mrs. Berry, Mrs. Cook, and Ms. D. I will never forget the great education I received here at Laurel Hall. I also give my best wishes to Mrs. Hayworth for a fast recovery. To my fellow graduates, many of whom I have known since kindergarten, thank you so much for making my time at Laurel Hall fun, exciting, and unexpected. I don't think I could ask for a better class to be a part of, and I'm going to miss so many of you next year. All of you have become like family, and it's going to be so hard to leave. To my parents, thank you for never ceasing to believe in me and giving me the strength and courage to become the person I am today. I would not be where I am without you. To my best friends especially, thank you so much for being the ones who know me better than anyone else, always being there for me, never letting me down, and being the best friends I could ever have. You are like my sisters. I love you all so much, and even though some of us are not going to the same high school, I know that we will all stay the closest friends. Elizabeth Foley once said, "The most beautiful discovery true friends make is that they can grow separately without growing apart." I believe that going to separate high schools will not make our friendships fade, but instead grow stronger. Today marks the end of our careers here at Laurel Hall and the beginning of something great. A new blank chapter in life, the pages are ours to fill with new experiences, friends, and opportunities. I look forward to the next 4 years, but I will also find myself looking back at the past 9 years. I wish the Laurel Hall class of 2011 the best of luck wherever they go, and I will remember each and every one of you for years to come. Thank you.
Every year, the eighth grade students are given an opportunity to choose a medley of songs that they wish to perform at graduation. As always, Mr. Hayworth works his magic, taking often very disparate songs and weaving them into an excellent and heartfelt arrangement. He also, and this year especially, he also usually finds some surprising and unexpected soloists to boost the program. I want to point out before we start, though, that we've got some hidden talent in the back, and that is are the students who are accompanying the medley, and that would be Ari on piano, and we've got we have Zare, Nick Bunsuka, and Aaron and Harrison on guitar, and Aiden on the drums. Okay. All right, the eighth grade class under the direction of Mr. Hayworth.
Our first song is To Stir With Love, but we would like to dedicate it to all of our teachers, male and female, here at Laurel Hall School, in every grade, from preschool through eighth. In fact, we'd like to ask all Laurel Hall faculty and staff to stand up as we sing To Stir With Love. We dedicate it to all of you, and thanks for everything you've done for us over the last 12 years of our lives.
Teachers for everything.
We love you.
You may be seated.
I'm sailing away, looking for the bird.
About you, when my kids graduated, I was like crying with this one. It was like very touching. We will hear from the three eighth grade homeroom teachers this year, Suzanne Bergstrom, Don Meyer, and Jennifer Jones.
Every teacher at Laurel Hall. Every teacher at Laurel Hall has waited in anticipation to have this class. They have a great reputation for being academically strong, great friends, and filled with enthusiasm. It is interesting how one set of kids can be like this for years. Whatever you as parents have done has worked. As you move on to your next school, don't forget the atmosphere you have created here. You have unique. People with unique skills and abilities can work together as a group and can become friends, excel academically, and win championships. You will never be forgotten by both me and the rest of the staff at Laurel Hall. Remember always what you have learned here. Thank you.
All right, I'm going to talk directly to you. Dearest class of 2011, I cannot believe how quickly this year has passed. I remember all of you filing into my classroom with wide eyes on the first day of school, and now you're graduating and moving on to the next crucial stage of your academic careers, high school. I have watched you grow into strong writers, critical thinkers, giving members of society, and even more devoted friends to one another. I am so thrilled to see what the next 4 years and beyond have in store for you. You are a truly unique class, full of dynamic personalities, and it has been such a joy to watch you balance your academics, extracurricular activities, and strong bonds with one another so beautifully. It is not always an easy task to juggle so many responsibilities, and I'm incredibly proud of your diligence and enthusiastic involvement. Thank you for making this school year so special. Thank you for making me laugh so often. And thank you for being as awesome and genuine as you are. Hold on tight to all of those wonderful qualities and carry them with you as you move on from Laurel Hall. The world is yours to explore and make the most of, so work hard and play hard because it flies by all too quickly. I expect great things from you, class of 2011, and cannot wait to hear all about your amazing accomplishments. Congratulations, I love you, and I will miss you terribly.
Okay, I'll make this really short. What everyone else said, ditto. Now, I have some secrets to share. So, close your ears. We've seen each other at our worst, haven't we? But we've also seen each other at our best. You know, listening to you guys speak, sing, and perform, it is true. Everything that people said about you and what you said about each other is right on. You are special. You are unique. You are gifted. Whatever that gift is, some of you don't even know what it is yet, but you're going to find it, and you're going to soar. And that's what's been a really fun waiting, anticipating, as Mr. Meyer said, for you guys to get up here in eighth grade. We've been waiting for you. It's been really fun. And you lived up to the expectation. You guys are awesome. And no matter what high school you're going to or college or path you choose, we at Laurel Hall, your family, your friends, will never forget this class of 2011. Because of your uniqueness, your specialness, and the qualities you've brought to this whole community of Laurel Hall. We are a big family, and you're just 75 more of our family members. But, as your classmates said, you're going to add to your family. But this family will never leave you. We'll always be there for you. So I'm going to leave with you with one little poem. Sometimes we don't know what the future holds for us, and that's an uncertain future. But a friend of mine wrote this poem, and she said, "Wisely enough, God does not let us skip ahead in the story of our lives, but rather leads us page by page to its understandable conclusion through Him. And so, as each of you faces an uncertain future, you can trust in God's promise, as expressed by the prophet Jeremiah. For I know the plans I have for you, saith the Lord. They are plans for good and not for evil, to give a future and a hope." And one of my favorite verses is from 2 Timothy 1:7. "For God did not give us a spirit of fear, but He gave us the spirit of power and love and a sound mind." So go forth and be awesome.
Now we will award the diplomas to the graduating class of 2011. Harrison Samuels. Chris Johansson. Michael Bryce Wilson. Yuri C. Ehrlich. Adrian Gomez. Mark Dylan Wallengren. Zare Kalustian. Aiden Raul Qualiaroli. Christopher Lawrence Collins. Austin Brian Swanson. John Andrew Carroll. Jacob Svenstrup. Peyton Massey. David William White. Aaron James Hagler.
Bowen Bailey. Jesse Manos. Eden Brazil. Logan Matthew Schwartz. Derek A. Tavares. John Young. Brandon Henry Wong. Donald Brian Palomino. Julia Emily Backlian. Sarah Jane McConnell. Jonathan Chi. Nicholas Bunsuka. Wallace Colin Newman. Ian Gregory Jost. Joshua Daniel Garner. Jack Moses Clayman. Sabrina Caserta. Nicholas E. Castagnon. Macy Schoberg. Nicholas Arthur Madsen. Hannah Zdenko Rudianne Kitlika. Colin Toby. Lauren Michelle Kelly. Justin Jun. Michelle Coco Derbartanian. Marcella Rose Dreith. Spencer William Kervorst. Paige Holhouse. London Lorraine Ruff. Dylan Jensen. Connor Maxwell. Megan Patrice Lizey. Mary Rose Mandato. Justin Benedict Thomas. Ryan Matthew Boyd. London Jade Powers. Allison Lourdes Osis. Kayla Michelle Hanna. Chelsea Abrahamian Mendez. Jake Bradford, Nigerian. Kai Logan Hamilton. Angelica Bakirian. Tyler Tisday Walski. Sage Capri Hancock Polanco. Tess Appablassa. Isabella Metasavage. Nathan Elijah Fuentes. Jacob Michael Christie. Cameron Douglas Thompson. Nicholas Sora Dura. Nicole Che. Cameron DeMatteis. Amanda Goldhaber. Aaron Orcutt. Ariana Rose Danilian. Sophia Pearl. Melanie Marie Darling. Jacqueline Nicole Ivy. Emily C. White. Brett Brennan. The graduating class of 2011.
Reminds me an awful lot of chapel. I need to give them the evil eye to quiet them down. Now you have earned the right to go on to Facebook to that page that says you know you've been to Laurel Hall when. And note that one of those lines is your pastor has purple hair.
Yes.
But we are blessed to have your children and we would like to bless them with a closing. I invite you all to please stand. Let us pray. Oh God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and that your love supporting us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I just wanted to say, this class makes everybody smile. And before they leave us, one of the things I did want to just say is that this is an example when we have parents and school and students all working together. You've been a great group of parents. You've been involved. You've stayed involved all the way through. We've had parents helping with, in eighth grade, we've had parents helping with our sports boosters, with our plays, being extremely involved with every aspect of the school, mock trial, all the wonderful things that we do. And this is the end result of you being involved and staying involved. In fact, I have to say this, that all the way through when we've had our galas, this eighth grade class has had the most fun table at our galas of parents. So keep involved with them, because this is what you get when you're involved in this foundational education. We're so proud of you, and just to remind you that the recessional that you'll hear is our middle school band, actually a recording of them.
This, as you probably remember, having been last year's seventh grade families, that there is a reception that's been planned for you by this year's seventh grade for you guys. So it's like a pay it forward. You did it last year. Now you get to reap the benefits. So, without further ado, the class of 2011 will be processing out, and just please stay seated until they are out.